Welcome to episode 12 of the Paranormal United States. This week we are in Idaho.
We are indeed. And there's one particular place in Idaho that I'm going to be talking about today, which is Pocatello High School. So Pocatello High School is among the most haunted places in the nation. Located in southeastern Idaho, Pocatello is one of the most historic cities in the Gem State. The area was first developed by fur trappers in the early 19th century and continued to see massive growth during the gold rush of the 1860s. It's fair to say that Pocatello has been unbelievably rich history. In fact, the town's extensive history may play a part in the fact that it's considered one of the most haunted towns in Idaho. However, one of the creepiest locations in this southern eastern city is Pocatello High School. And thanks to video footage and various reports, the high school is considered one of the most haunted high schools in Idaho and maybe even the entire country. So going back to 2014, security footage from the high school went viral. The footage was taken during the school's winter break when not a soul was supposed to be in the building. However, the video, which I'll show you in a moment, shows a mysterious shadowy figure that walks in and out of the bathroom and down the hallway. Meanwhile, the hallway's lights flicker on and off. So it's been said that the figure is definitely not a person, and as you'll see, appears not to be, but it does move like a person. And the video caused a lot of excitement amongst ghost hunters and some news stations. If you scour the internet, you'll find that a lot of people have seen the video as some of the best ghost footage ever captured. Cool. Now, obviously, that's a big claim. But when you see the video footage, you'll see that it definitely shows something. But whether or not it's a spirit, that's for you to think about.
Awesome. Can't wait.
And the reason why so many people believe the figure in the video is actually a ghost is because the high school, for quite some time, has a reputation for being haunted. Both faculty and students agree that there's something off about the building. As you can see, this is the older picture of the building back in the day. Toilets randomly flush, doors mysteriously close, and some have reported either seeing or feeling the presence of an apparition. But what is exactly haunting the school? Don't know. It was originally constructed in 1892. And in 1914, the school burned to the ground and had to be reconstructed. Safe to say that many of the school structures boast a long history and they make for a perfect setting for a ghost story. They also believe that the school's ghost is the spirit of a girl who killed herself in the school sometime between 1930 and 1950. So there's quite a broad range of dates there. And it's believed that the girl made a suicide pact with her friend and the next day she hanged herself from the locker. However, the friend didn't go through with it. So quite an interesting sort of back story.
Yeah, that. Quite a bit of history there.
Yeah.
Really old as well, like 130 originally anyway.
Yeah, yeah. And the fact that it was burnt down and was reconstructed, like I just mentioned, it does appear to sort of like lend weight to the fact that something odd going on. There's no
details. It looks creepy as well.
It does. Some people also say they can smell a strong scent of a girl's favorite perfume lingering in the air at random times, and others have reported seeing an apparition of a young girl wandering the hallways. Although the story of the girl hasn't been confirmed, there have been at least 6 confirmed deaths at the high school.
Jesus.
Yeah, so Pocatello High School may well be one of the most haunted places in the nation, and it's likely the most haunted school in Idaho. After all, it has the stories and video to prove it. So what I'm going to do now is I'll show you the video, and you'll also hear from some students that, and past students that have actually experienced stuff. And let us know what you think. And we'll come back after the video clip and discuss a bit further.
The lights in this hallway started to flash on and off all of a sudden. People went back and reviewed the security footage. There was a translucent figure that seemed to be walking through the halls going in and out of this bathroom. Everybody that comes in this building can have an experience, and I think that was just one of them.
Sometimes when we'd be sitting in class, the door would just slowly close or slowly open, and our teachers would just be like, oh, don't mind that, it's just the ghost.
Pocatello High School wasn't just a high school. It was a gathering place. People would come here and have picnics on the lawn. They had parades. There were all kinds of things going around this building.
This room is known as the heart of Pocatello High School. And the reason why is because after the fire, there was a part of the building that was actually salvaged, and this was it. And something very interesting happened here. It was so interesting that I actually made it the very first story in my book, The Ghost of Pocatello High School.
And it's a story told to me by the janitor that was with us our first investigation.
He told me he was mopping right around in this area. He looks up, and in that doorway, there was a young boy standing there. He said that he took his mop, and he turned and he put it in the bucket. And when he turned around, the boy was gone.
When I hear these stories from these janitors, I truly believe that they are having these experiences, because I can feel the honesty and the sincerity coming from them when they tell me, hey, yeah, this is what's going on and this is what I experienced.
At this point, we're gonna walk in these doors, we're gonna walk up the stairs, and we are gonna meet in the library.
The story of the librarian who hung herself on the chandelier after being left at the altar by her fiance.
We can't verify who she was exactly when it happened, but what we can do is we can go back over 60 years of documented sightings of the librarian in these windows. So if you're ever driving by, look on up and you might see her.
He saw, actually cleaned up the building, locked up, was standing out on the sidewalk out front, turned back and saw the librarian up in the window. Never came back here. It scared him so bad.
One of the stories about Pocatello High is the story of a suicide pact between two girls who said that they were going to hang themselves in their lockers.
The girl who had her locker on the top floor wound up not hanging herself, but the girl who had her locker on the bottom floor did. And for many years after she hung herself, that locker was haunted, made noise, rattled all the time, disturbed classes. People even said the books flew out of it sometimes. The school eventually wound up taking the entire row of lockers out and making a janitor's closet out of it. But the haunting continued in the bathroom that was right next to it. Today, girls go into that bathroom and they say lights come on and off, toilets flush by themselves, but most of all, they smell the strong scent of lilac perfume, and that's how you know that she's here. People may say, well, ghost hunting's just kind of a thrill seeking. I prefer to call it para-archaeology. And the reason why is because just like archaeology, we're looking for remnants of human behavior. And if ghosts do exist, if spirits do exist, that's what we're finding. If there is somebody in this building, it's because this building meant something to them and they choose to be here.
As you can hear from that report and those the guy that works there, some strange happenings, as I'd mentioned previous, but also the fact that there's a librarian that appears to haunt the place as well. So
that's only one of the most haunted high schools, and there must be some of the haunted high schools around.
I know. It's like where I live, we got like two high schools or secondary schools, as we call them in the UK, sort of within close proximity in the sort of town. But although one of them is supposed to be haunted, I wouldn't say that they're all haunted. And there's a list of which one's more haunted than the others. It seems and as we do these episodes, it does appear that the US does have a lot of haunted areas, certainly compared to the UK, considering we've got a longer documented history of haunted areas. Yeah. So
remind a bit of when we had Craig Bryant on the show. He talked about a high school in Lancashire, in England, which has had a few similar things, apparitions and things being moved and noises being heard and like instruments being played when no one's up in the music room.
That's the drummer, wasn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
So maybe it is a thing with schools as well, that sort of the energy of the kids and stuff like that. But yeah, an interesting story. One of many, actually, in Idaho. It seems to be a very paranormal state. And there was lots of places. There's a place called the Crowley House. There were cemeteries where there's also a two graves next to each other, one but with the name of Ware on it and one with the name of Wolf on it. There's also one of the cemeteries in Idaho where if you knock on the top of the grave, you can hear something knocking underneath as well. So it does appear to have a very rich history of paranormal occurrences. So
yeah, and if you're listening to the audio only version, we put the video that you just heard on our Facebook, so you can go and watch the video and watch the security camera footage of the apparition as well.
So thanks for joining us on this episode of Paranormal United States, which we delved into Idaho.